top of my head. Hold on. Welcome to Backhand Sally After Noche! I want to host a watching party. Here we go. Watching it together. I'm watching on this phone. I am live from BS Pulse Studios this week. Gonna play some songs. Usually we start with a song, but today I'm gonna start with our Let's Make a Drink. It is summertime. Typically I'm a vodka drinker, but today I wanted to make a rum drink. Let me turn that down so I don't have an echo. I wanted to make a rum drink, so that's what I'm making. I'm making a mojito. Now, I want... I'll also do something else. But it won't let me do it, so I'm just gonna keep talking for a minute. Okay, so I have a pre-made drink. This is a mojito with watermelon. And it's really good, and I'm going to show you how to make a standard mojito. We're going to start with the standard mojito, and then we're going to move in. I'm going to add strawberries to the other one that I'm going to make. So I'll have two of them to drink while we do the show. And these are pretty strong. They have a lot of rum in them. So in case you didn't know, the mojito is considered the national drink of Cuba. And it's a mint-based and white rum drink. So I've already peeled off some of the mint leaves. I'm going to go through it kind of quickly. Make sure you do it in a sturdy glass because you don't want to break the glass when you muddle the mint and the lime. And do about 10 mint leaves. I've already broken off most of the ones I need. And then we're going to squeeze one lime wedge. So you'll need mint and lime, preferably fresh limes. You could use lime juice if you wanted to, but it wouldn't be as good. So if you're just joining us, this is Backhand Sally After Noche, and we're making drinks to get started with our show. So we're making a mojito, and we're making a Backhand Sally mojito, and that just means it has strawberries in it. So we've got 10 mint leaves, and we're gonna squeeze a lime wedge into here. My mom gave me this really cool lime squeezer thing, but of course I don't have it here in the studio, but next time. All right, so you squeeze one in there, and then we're gonna muddle that. We're gonna muddle real fast. This is why I already have a drink made. So, it's like TV magic. Muddle, 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 muddle. And then after you get that muddled, and the reason you muddle it is to release the mint oil in with the lime juice. And after you do that, then we're gonna add some sugar. I already have this pre-measured out. And most recipes call for 2 tablespoons. That's a lot of sugar. I just do like a tablespoon and a little bit. That's enough for me. I'm going to pour that in there. You could do it without sugar maybe, or NutraSweet or Splenda or something like that. Or you could use grenadine. I don't like grenadine, so that's why I'm using sugar. And then after you do that, you do another 2 lime wedges. Yeah. And you're also going to add your fruit at this point. So if you wanted to add fruit to your mojito, you add it before you add your ice and your rum. All right. There we go. So now we've got 3 squeezes of lime in here, 10 mint leaves, and a tablespoon, and a bit of sugar. We're going to muddle all that together again. Thank you, Brock, for playing my background music today. We're going to muddle all that up. Muddle, 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 muddle. And this isn't as muddled as much as I prefer, but to move along. and you're going to add your strawberries. And you're actually going to muddle those as well. I just like to say the word muddle a lot. So we're going to muddle these. In case you're just joining me, yes, I'm going to play music. But this is our variety show, Backhand Sally After Noche. So I do some talking, I make some drinks, and then I'll play some music. So I've added strawberry to this. This is the Backhand Sally Mojito, or it's just a strawberry mojito, but strawberries aren't my favorite fruit. After you've muddled, and muddle the strawberry in. Muddle. And do it pretty good, because you want all that strawberry juice to mix in with the mint oil. It is the oil of the mint that gives it the flavor. I am making mojito. I feel like people are just joining me wondering, what is she doing? I'm making a drink. All right, now the fun part. You're going to put ice. And you put ice in the cup almost till it's full. Not completely full, because the something about this being really cold is part of what makes it good. And then I do a full shot of, in a small glass like that, of rum, white rum. I suppose you could use dark rum, but I don't think it would taste very good. So we're going to use white rum. I wouldn't advise pouring that over a keyboard under a normal rule. There we go. And then, depending on what you like, you can top that off with club soda. I do not like soda at all, ever. So I always just use ginger ale. You could use water, you could use nothing, I suppose, but the soda just kind of gives it that fizz, which is also a key component of the mojito. Yeah. What is that noise you're making? All right. I know Lisa Haggard likes to see all of the steps, so I tried to show you everything, and then that's it. You can add a piece of mint or some lime to make it garnish it at the top. But I'm not going to do that. I am going to drink that. So now I have two rum drinks to drink while I play music for y'all. Oh gosh, that's so good. I'll put the ingredients and the directions in the comment section of this video so you know how to make it. But this is the Backhand Sally Mojito, which just essentially is a regular mojito with strawberries and ginger ale instead of soda. I made a watermelon one earlier, same ingredients, just instead of strawberry, use watermelon. You could use any fruit you wanted to. There, blackberry would probably be good. Okay, so over the week, a lot of crazy things have been happening. I'll get into that a little bit later, but let's play a song. So Brock took a poll and asked people some of the songs that they absolutely hated, and we had quite a list of songs. But I'm going to play a song that I actually like this song, but I can see why people don't. The first time I heard it was on the Boogie Nights soundtrack, and it's, what's the name of it? I Got a Brand New Key, and it's by a lady named Melanie something or another. Anyway, that's not important. So I'm Melanie Safka, in case you wanted to look her up. I'm going to do that song for you real quick. Brand New Key by Melanie Safka. This was on our list of songs that people hate. I actually like this song, but if you hate it, I bet you know all the words anyway when we get to the chorus. You can sing along if you'd like to. Let me put it on the right pitch. That's not loud enough. I rode my bicycle past your window last night. What key did you lower that to? You didn't lower the key? just for pieces at home. I ride my bike, I roller skate, I don't drive. Don't go too fast, but I go pretty far. For someone who don't drive, I've been all around the world. Some people say I done all right for a girl. Well, I got a brand new pair of roller skates. You got a brand new key. I think that we should get together and try them out, see. Been looking around a while, you got something for me, oh. I got a brand new pair of roller skates, you got a brand new key. Alright, that's enough of that song. Alright, another one that we got on the list of songs that everybody loves to hate was Billy Ray Cyrus' Achy Breaky Heart. Now, I gotta be honest with you, I don't hate this song. I have never hated this song, but I also like Nickelback, so there's probably something wrong with me. For the three of you that are watching, I have a way to look at your comments because they do not pop up on my phone for some reason. I don't know why. Interesting. All right. If you have something you want to hear, you might request it, and I might play it or not. Here we go. Lisa Dix likes that song. Kay likes that song. They all like, people actually like that song. It was just one of the ones on the list of songs that people didn't like. Now I'm going to eat this mat. Okay. Achy Breaky Heart. We're going to do that one. Again, this was just a list that we were given of songs that people don't like. Well, you can tell the world never was my girl. You can burn my clothes when I'm gone. Or you can tell your friends just what a fool I've been. And laugh and joke about me on the phone. And you can tell my arms to go back to the farm. You can tell my feet to hit the floor. Well, you can tell my lips to tell my fingertips. They won't be reaching out for you no more. Well, don't tell my heart, my achy breaky heart, I just don't think he'd understand. And if you tell my heart, my achy breaky heart, he might blow up and kill this man. Well, you can tell your mom I moved to Arkansas, or you can tell your dog by my leg, or tell your brother Cliff, whose fist can tell my lip. To just sit around and play, I suppose. But hey, it made Billy Ray Cyrus famous. So any song that can do that for somebody is something. There was another song. And I have to agree with this one that it is a really weird, terrible, terrible song. I don't understand it. But apparently it made these people very famous. They recently divorced last year after like 55 years of marriage. I don't get that, but probably not that long. Just seemed like a long time. So Captain and Tennille. The song is called Muskrat Love. I'm not going to play this whole song because it is whatever. I guarantee there's got to be somebody out there who likes it, though, because it was like a hit song. And, you know, whatever. Are you playing something else? All right. I got to get to the good part. These words are so weird. Muskrat Susie, Muskrat Sam, doing the jitterbug and Muskrat Man, and they shimmy, and Sam is so skinny, and they whirl and they twirl and they tango, singing and jingling the Django. What's a Django? Floating like the heavens above. It looks like muskrat love. I saw you giggle that song. Again, I'm going, if you're just joining us, I'm Ginger with Backhand Sally. This is our show, Backhand Sally After Noche. I'm just kind of tootling through some songs from a poll we took, songs that people hate. There were some songs on that list that I was surprised that people hate them, but I guess everybody has their own taste. Hotel California was on that list. Fancy was on that list. These are not songs I would think people hate, but apparently they do. I don't know who some of these people are, but thank y'all for joining me, the ones of you who are here. Let's play a real song. A real song. I have an iPad down there, so I can turn my patch a little bit. I can't decide if I want to drink my strawberry mojito or my watermelon mojito, but they're both really good. Boogie Nights is a great soundtrack. There's another soundtrack that's really, really good. Pulp Fiction. So I did a couple of these songs on another little live thing the other day. But I'm gonna do these songs. Do it now. Switch patches. I saw it in the movie theater. I was 3 years old. Dating myself. I'm trying to think of another song to do. I kind of want to, felt like I was going to tell y'all some jokes, but I'm terrible at telling jokes or telling a whole lot of stories. So I'll just tell you stories about songs and why I like to play them. Somebody else did Muskrat Love? Oh, it wasn't originally by them? How could it? I'll take your word for that, Kay, because it's a weird, silly, silly song. lately I've kind of been on the kick of doing songs from soundtracks and whatnot. Did you know yesterday was Judy Garland, would have been her 98th birthday. She died kind of young at 47. I feel like back then 47 wasn't considered young, but it's considered pretty young now. Considering J-Lo and Shakira, Gwen Stefani, and all of those people. I'm gonna do a drinking song. I've done this song before, but I've never really do a little different. They try to make me go to rehab. I said no. Backhand Sally Mojito, which is essentially a regular mojito with strawberries, and I use ginger ale instead of club soda because I don't like soda water. War wrote? I don't think we're talking about the same songs. I hope not. Anyway, I'm going to do a song that I did yesterday on my Ginger Tales page. This is going way back, like 1939 back. It was the first song I ever heard Judy Garland sing, as it was the first song that most people heard Judy Garland sing. Somewhere Over the Rainbow. I know that this movie... Hi, Oliver. It's been so long since I've seen you, Oliver. I feel like I need to come and get a socially distanced hug. I don't know how to do that. So, The Wizard of Oz, if you read anything about The Wizard of Oz, has a very interesting history, as do a lot of movies from that time period, mostly to do with the cast and the way Judy Garland was treated and some crazy things that happened. So, I'm not going to go into all that, but you can Google it and learn. Try not to kick that over, please. And learn all of that yourself. But I am going to sing a song. I'm going to sing Somewhere Over the Rainbow from the movie The Wizard of Oz. Let's see. G. Song was written for the movie and has like four verses, Another thing, if you want to Google, and the other verses are actually prettier, but this is the one that everybody knows, so. Lisa Hager, I see you just joined. You'll have to go back and watch the beginning, because that's... What? Oh, Great Balls of Fire. Which sad song, Cody?
Google it. Which one?
There's a lot of Jerry Lee Lewis songs. You're going to need me to learn that one? Okay. So this one is watermelon, a watermelon mojito. I'm going to go back to that. And this is a strawberry mojito. I'm calling this one the Backhand Sally Mojito. Google any mojito recipe and I'll teach you how to make it and muddle some watermelon or strawberry into it. And that's it. The differences that I make is I never use grenadine. I always use regular sugar. And then I use ginger ale instead of club soda because I don't like club soda. I have to take a break and drink my drink. Okay, find it. See if I can play it. While we wait, also, so if you're here and you haven't already, check out our website. There's some new things on there, backhandsellingmusic.com. You can buy our album there, and you can also, it'll take you to all the places where you can stream it. It's just like one easy page, click the music page, and it's all right there. I'll add that to the description up top. We are playing some live shows again, which is fantastic. Can't wait. We're playing a private a couple weeks ago. We played in Rockwall at this place called Vinecrafters. And if you are within an hour driving distance, it's worth your drive. We will be back there at the end of June. This Saturday, we're playing a private party. Our next public gig is actually the 4th of July in Kaufman, Texas at Craft Cork and Barrel. Everything else is, I take that back. Vinecrafters at the end of the month. June 25th or 6th, and then 4th of July at Craft Cork and Barrel in Kaufman, and July 11th, we will be back at Yogi's Home Plate. So we're slowly but surely coming back as a full man. I was waiting on Cody, so I'm going to find another song. Nope. Why would I not have this? Hold, please. Oh, I know what it is. Because it didn't save it with the person's name. I'm not a super big boogie-oogie piano player. Nobody cares about this stuff, but my journey as a piano player has been a very long road. I started when I was young, taking a lot of piano lessons, and then kind of didn't have a piano or a way to do it for a long time, and then I got a keyboard, and then needed to play it for the band because it just made sense. So I try new things. Get a bigger glass. You just want me to mix them together, Kay? Kay, you have a great idea, but I don't need a bigger glass. Now let's see what this tastes like. Kay's giving me samples. We have to have a drinking party again soon, Kay. Oh my gosh. That's even better than just strawberry or just watermelon. Of course it is. Of course it's a lot more rum mixed together. I was waiting on Kay. Don't need a bigger glass. I was going to give y'all a PSA. If anybody owns a Chrysler Pacifica van from 2017 to 2020, there is a recall that you should pay attention to. These cars are spontaneously combusting. They are just catching on fire. They recommend that you do not park it in your garage or a parking facility that is enclosed because it could catch on fire randomly and then catch your building on fire. It could also catch on fire while you're driving it. So if you have a 2017 to a 2020 Chrysler Pacifica, you should take it to your dealership and get that bug fixed. Yes, you were right, Kay. It is so good. Like, really good. I don't know. It's summer. I've been drinking vodka for so long, and I love vodka, but I gotta switch it up. So rum is going to be the new drink for a while. Mojitos, mojitos, mojitos. All right, Cody's taking too long. Does anybody want to learn boogie oogie piano with me? It's kind of boring. When I come on over, baby, a whole lot of shaking going on. I said, now come on over, baby, a whole lot of shaking going on. Shaking going on. That's about as good as I get. It's one of those things I have to practice a lot before I can do it in public. Thanks, Cody. Did you like that? I'm here all day. I'm going to teach Marley some lessons while she's in town. Yeah, you're much better. I can do this part. It's the bass part. Do it. It's hard for me to sing and to play at the same time. Thanks, Cody.
Find that song.
I'm gonna do another song from. I'm gonna do another movie song. Today is just movie songs, just randomness with Ginger today. I should have been more prepared, but I've been spending a lot of time this week trying to figure out logistics of things, and didn't get as prepared for the show as possible. But I do like to go live with y'all and touch base with you. We miss out on so many gigs because of Corona, and now there's other things going on. So I think music is kind of one of those things that allows us all to come together and touch base with one another and talk to each other on the same level sometimes. Music is, it's just kind of a stereotypical thing to say that music is a language of love or a universal language, because it is. Everybody likes music, even though if it's not different kinds. Did you like that? It was fantastic. I'm reading your comments, so I'm looking down and reading comments on a different device than what I'm on right here. Alright, I'm gonna do this song. I hope it's not too loud.
Watching in slow motion now.
is a good movie. Top Gun is a good movie, and there's another song from that movie. We'll save that, though, for another week. I don't want to play it all by myself. I've been doing just songs that I like to play today on Backhand Sally after Noche. A lot of movie theme songs. I've been watching a lot of TV and a lot of movies lately, and I did recently watch Top Gun, and they are making a remake of that. I'm interested to see that. It's going to have Jennifer Connelly as the female lead this time, as opposed to Kelly McGillis. I read an article where Kelly McGillis said that they didn't even ask her to be in the remake. I'm just going to leave that there. So, speaking of remakes, I'm actually very excited about a remake this year. It's not a remake. It's a part two that's coming out. Okay. Hold on one second. Hold tight. I'm still here. It's a part two that's coming out of Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. I guess you never looked that song up, Cody, so look it up and I'll learn it for next time. Next week. Next week we might be doing this on Wednesday night instead of Thursday night. Stay tuned for that. Make sure that you have followed us and you like us here on this page, facebook.com/backhandsallymusic. Follow us on all the things, Instagram, and we're going to switch over and do our first live stream to Twitch after this. So go to twitch.com, look up Backhand Sally, we're the only one on there, and you'll find us and follow us. If you're not on Twitch, then you'll miss this, but I'm going to download that. I'm actually going to put that on our website with a video that we do on Twitch in a little bit, and we're going to be playing some originals over on Twitch and a couple of covers, some different ones, maybe the same ones, but I'm going to do one more song, and then I'm going to let y'all go. Thanks for hanging out with me. Next week, we're going to be doing it from a different location and doing some different themes, so every week the show will get a little different. If there's any songs you want to hear, put it in the comment and let me know. Lucky Old Sun, that's the name of the song? I don't know that song. I'll learn it for next week. I don't think I could just fake it. Maybe. I feel like all of his songs are... he's really good at it and he can use his feet. That's when I'll know I've made it, when I can play the keyboard with my feet. Like Jerry Lee Lewis. I'm trying to say, shall I do an original? Yes. Maybe. I can't play that song. Yeah, so if you have a Twitch account or you know somebody who does, share us with them, Backhand Sally, and tell them to go over to Twitch and check us out there. It's something different that we're going to be doing probably every week as well. We're going to follow up our Backhand Sally after Noche with a Twitch live stream as well. I don't remember that one. What song to do? Sometimes when you know a lot of songs, it's hard to narrow it down. Okay, I will look it up on YouTube and I'll learn it for next week. Lucky Old Sun. I've done a lot of slow songs today. Might as well just stay with that. All right. I'm going to play... an original and then going to let y'all go. Salvation from all the so I better move along and try to stay strong. But I need a little grace. Oh, a little grace to help me on my way. Just a little faith to get me through the day. Twitch.com. BackhandSallyMusic.com is the best place to find everything out about us. All of our shows are there. Bands in town, follow us there and you'll miss none of our gigs. Our next live show is June 25th and that's at Vinecrafters from 7 to 10 p.m. in Rockwall, Texas. And then we have a 4th of July show in Kaufman at Craft Cork and Keg. And that's going to be a big one regardless of what the city thing is. We're going to be bringing it and partying and you can hear us sing the national anthem. All right. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you next week.